Okay.
Let's try this again. I should lower the volume on this request. Yeah, so... that was interesting. I just barely reached the stage one boss. Got hit by a rocket from the top of the screen that I didn't see. And then I was just kind of frozen there for, like, several seconds. Mouse cursor frozen. Couldn't do anything. Couldn't access Task Manager. Complete hard lock. So I had to pull the fucking cord and let it sit for a bit and restart. I do think this is in part to this stupid fucking Oregon heat wave that's been going on since for over a week now. My apartment doesn't have air conditioning, which is makes this pretty uncomfortable to deal with, quite frankly. I have some fans turned on. You can probably hear them in the background. I actually lowered them before I started streaming. And that's why the heat is pretty much why I hadn't really been streaming too much in the early evening, which I've been wanting to do. So, yeah. I could start playing this again. It might happen again. I don't know. I'm starting to get the feeling that maybe I'm not going to be able to stream as much of this as I wanted. Because I think it's more fun in these online main tournaments just to, you know, just to stream your play. Let everybody else see what you're doing. Have your play recorded. Some people would rather hide their play. That's cool. But I figure, I might as well start streaming a little bit. But, I picked the worst possible time to run a tournament. Or rather, Oregon picked the worst possible time to actually go into consecutive 90 degree days. And this is going on for at least another week. I think by like next Friday it might be down to the high 80s. Which I guess is a little bit of improvement, but... at least that first stage one run wasn't a super great game. It was an acceptable score for stage one, by my standards anyway. Yeah, there's some funky stuff going on with the weather this year, I guess. Sure, it's gonna hit the northeast too. Hey, Delar, how's it going? Alright. Not really down in. Try this again. Oh. Look at that noise. Take the worst possible time to try it up. I'm just gonna keep going. This is gonna keep going, really? And then it stops. Oh, wow, I picked a great night to do this. Okay, let's try this again. That's my new catchphrase, let's try this again. What else is gonna fucking go wrong? Thank you. I mean, I'm glad that that lockup only happened on the first stage. Only was screaming for like, what, 10 minutes maybe? Get through this boss without the computer dying. Oh, hey, running wild. Hey, wolf. Thanks, Delar. That's more of a general Shock Troopers website than a review, but also an unfinished website that I never finished. But anyway, I'm gonna fuck it. I'm turning my fans up. I don't want this to die again. Fans are probably gonna come out as being really loud in the audio, but I don't give a fuck. I still need to play a game of Star Force at some point. I hadn't because all that furious button mashing is gonna make me work up a sweat. Which sounds sad and pathetic, but in this heat, I'm already kind of sweating. Like, it's a good thing I don't have a player cam because I'm shirtless right now. Maybe that'd be better. Bring in the viewers. Not on my selection, it's your time, yeah. Gekiso, or Gekiso, however you pronounce it. That's actually a really fun game. I'd never played it before this tournament. I never heard of it either. There's still some things I don't understand about that game. It's fun. I mean, I can definitely push my score higher. Last night was the first time I really played it. I had no idea what I was doing. I slowly started to learn it. Oh, I missed it. Good job. I'd probably enjoy it more if you could actually switch between power-ups on the fly instead of being stuck with a power-up until you run out. And you kind of have to watch the bottom of the screen once you run out to make sure you get the start using the next one. I don't know, there's some weird design choices in that game. But man, how the fuck did that happen? The text file I keep of all my Shock Trooper scores just so I know if my score is on pace or not. Then again, I'm playing the original ROM set, so can't grind as many points on Valley 4 as I can on the revised version. So this is not going to be a 30 million point score either way, but that's fine. This rate. Boy, if I don't fuck up more, it's gonna be like 28 million at most. But yeah, there's still some good games that I haven't played for the tournament yet. I haven't played Star Force. I like Star Force. I haven't played Bubble Symphony. Probably Bubble 2. I haven't played Turbo Outrun because Turbo Outrun's a good game, but I actually have to put in a little bit of time to learn those stages. I'm not that familiar with Turbo. I'm only familiar with regular Outrun. Trap? Yeah, I have played Starfighter. It's not an experience I want to talk about. Holy crap. Played Starfighter on like on the first night I was streaming these games. I don't think I've ever said what the fuck so many times in my life in such a short period of time. Tiff beat my score on it too, that motherfucker. I like like how nobody's even gotten past like the third stage on that. Yeah, I thought Battle Garaga was going to be the worst shmup in this tournament. And then I played Starfighter. I'm just saying that to troll because I know people love Battle Garaga, but I fucking hate it. Unfortunately, with... I think I might have to play it for this team. Fuck it, I'll just play everything. Seems like you have a better chance to get multiple shot kills when they're running away and they have their back to you. So any situation where you can force an enemy to run away is actually a good thing if you can catch them in time while they're running away. That's the hard part. Thank you. the end of this. Actually, I only picked up one red gem so far, and that was when there were no enemies on the screen. What was that the first game I played with, when my computer locked up? I can't remember. I guess I'll let my computer lock up now. Not that this is the best run or anything. It's to play some games. Fuck that up. Yeah, Delar, you should definitely play team mode, especially on this one life version of the game. Like, there is no reason to play Lonely Wolf mode. Because on Lonely Wolf mode, you only have one life. On the clone ROM set, you get three lives. So, you know, you get three different, three bomb refills. Once you run out of, special bombs, you know, you get another life, another set of bombs. On Lonely Wolf, you only get one life. And, you know, one number of bombs. When you have three characters, you have three different bombs that you can switch between. And just being able to switch between characters in general is a huge part of this game. Like, having a fast character like Milky for general levels is great. And then having a character like Big Mama with, you know, the double gunshot, and she takes less damage, that's great for bosses. That's a big part of this game. You want a, fucking red gem. I'm not gonna blame that on me talking. Blame that on that energy. Like, you want a balanced team that's good for, whatever route you're playing. Like, every, beginning of every level, like, it shows that star rating, and you get a life bonus. That tells, like, how fast that character can move on that level. It changes from level to level based on which character you are. So if you have a character that's good at the jungle route, like Big Mama, you want to put her on your team if you're planning on playing the jungle route. And of course, you need to see the ratings ahead of time if you're going to build a team based on that. But either way, like, just in general, it's best to make a team that consists of either Big Mama or Southern Cross, because they have the same stats in terms of, the life bar, because of how much damage they take, and the double shot. Although, you know, Big Mama's better for certain stages, and Southern Cross is better for other stages. I think Southern Cross's bomb is actually slightly better. But either way, just have Big Mama or Southern Cross on your team just to have, you know, a big tank character. A big tank character. And at least one fast character. levels faster. And the third character, I guess, can be whoever you want. Preferably a character that's well suited for your for the route you're playing. Either way, just pick team mode, even if you don't know what the best team should be. Just having team mode is an advantage. I think most people instinctively pick Lonely Wolf mode when they start out. Even like the first time I played the game, I was like, oh, Milky, I'm going to misuse her. But, and then slowly I discovered the advantages of playing team. So if I haven't said it enough, always play team mode in this game. Always. Always play team mode. Yeah, the team I'm using right now is Dirk Leader up above the female characters. Milky's good for most of the stages just because she moves quickly on the stage. She moves quickly. Marie B moves quickly too on the stage, but it's the next stage. For some reason, Milky has a 0-star rating, so she moves really slowly. But Marie has a... I remember 2 or 3, but either way, she moves faster. Even though Marie and Milky have the same, they basically have the same speed stat. So in theory, they should always be moving the same speed, but it changes from stage to stage for some reason. They want the characters to be better in certain routes. Gem. Looking like... could be a 29 million point game. Probably gonna be in the 28 million range though. What? Gem! A gem! That's too bad. That's too bad! Oh, why did I do that? Another problem. Oh, did I just... I did fuck up, didn't I? Thank you. I don't actually like boss milking, but... And my reasons for hating Garaga extend beyond the boss milking anyway. Yeah, the deadly pistol knife. Too bad for the one life ROM set. These are my standards. It's actually gonna be a 30 million game. I was wrong. As long as I don't fuck up the close range kill on the last boss, which has happened to me before on a run that would have been a new personal best for me at the time. I'm pretty sure that was back when I was in like the probably the 24, 25, 26 million range. I just remember having one game where all I had to do was get that 1.6 million kill on the last boss with a close range stab. Instead, I got bumped away and shot him instead, and that only gives you 800,000 instead of 1.6. Man, was I pissed. Good times. Jetpack assholes. That's fine. Use our last rocket on them. Switch to Marie. Oh shit! I have my last set of rockets. And unload. Take it. I'll consider that a successful run. My computer didn't lock up. Yay! I'm actually using a slightly different button layout compared to the Neo Geo layout. I'm playing on a Hori HRAP right now, and I'm using the top three buttons as ABC, and then the bottom left button as the D button for partner switching. Because usually, you know, it's the other way around. You have the bottom left is A, then B, C, D. Which works too, but... No, Dan, I didn't actually top my high score on the... Oh, or unless you're talking about the tournament, yeah. Yeah, I beat the Zerstzegor. But... Obviously, that's not a personal best for me. Although it should be pointed out that I'm playing on the rare one life version instead of the three lives version. I forgot to specify that we should play the three lives version in the tournament, but everybody would have fucked up and used the one life version anyway, so. Whatever, no big loss. I don't seriously play on the one life version because that's not the version I ever see in the arcades. Three lives version, my best score is 32.7 million. 32.7 million in MAME. On an arcade cabinet, I got 32.6 million, so right behind it. And I've never, ever seen the one life version in an arcade. And yet, for some reason, it's the parent ROM set in MAME. But whatever. wonder if the enemy commander, his voice actor is listed as Meijin Takahashi. It's like, is that the same Meijin Takahashi that was, Master Takahashi from the Hudson's Adventure Island games? I don't think I've ever gotten confirmation on that, but he's about to laugh right here, by the way. Could be the same guy. I don't know. If it is, yeah. It's a fun trivia factoid for you. So it was 30,235,800. Right. Does this game censor the initials ass? Good question. I have not actually tried that. It's easy enough to get on the high score list, though. I was recording this as an imp, so... Oh no, I wasn't recording this! Fuck! Oh, I forgot to record the imp file. Ah, that's okay. I got a Twitch archive. Assuming this archive doesn't get blown up. Actually, yeah. Now you've got me curious. I guess I'll test it out. But then again, this game wasn't made by SNK. It was made by Source. No, it does not censor it. How about that? Well, there you go. Tell the world you're an ass man. Okay, well, let's really work up a sweat. I can't believe I didn't record the IMP file. Shit. Speaking of Meijin Takahashi, we're gonna get some fast firing. Not as good as Starfighter. Very few games can can aspire to be on the same level of quality that Starfighter is. It's not really fair to everybody else. Point bonus Cleopatra is. I think it happens around stage 12. Watched a replay just to make sure I could figure out where it was. Oh shit. That was stupid. That's a bad start. Oh, come on! That was the last one! Shit. Those little question marks, you have to shoot the, seven of them are frowny faces, and one's a smiley face. It gives you an extra life. I shot seven of the eight. I couldn't find the smiley face. Man, now I really want to restart. Let's stick it out. Get some practice in. Why did I do that? Holy shit. Why did I think I could outrun that? Thank you. What's up, George? Team Mark! Mark boys. It's getting dark in this room too, and I need to turn a light on, but I'm recording this so I can't pause. This sucks. Whoa! Yeah, okay, let's jump this game. Okay, that was a warm-up game. Yeah, let's call it a warm-up. What's up, Dan, man?
Thank you.
late, Koji. I just finished Shock Troopers. Oh yeah, I should probably change the Twitch plane thing. Yeah, for this game in particular, you really need some kind of joystick that really helps in being able to fire quickly. You can't fire that quickly on a pad. Or keyboard, for that matter. Ah, sorry, Koji. Wasn't gonna take me multiple attempts to get a good score. It did take me two, since my computer sort of overheated or something in the first game. Working heat. Fire quickly just so you can get that 50,000 point bonus is a really helpful thing too. If you can't get the 50,000 point bonus, you're kinda... Fuck, I thought I got through that. You're missing out on a lot of points. Thank you. Okay. Usually the hitbox in this game is not very forgiving, but... Sick. HRAP V3SA. It's a PlayStation 3 stick. Just have it plugged into the PC. Sometimes I play on an Xbox 360 Madcast Fight Stick Pro. And sometimes I just play on an Xbox 360 pad, depending on the game. Month like this, you need a stick with good buttons. There's buttons that let you fire quickly. If I tried to play this on a keyboard, I think I would end up breaking the keyboard. Very, very few games in MAME I would ever consider using a keyboard on. I can play the Super Spy on keyboard though. Thank you. remember what the trick is with the, this quote-unquote bosses. You can sort of get them to go, always go left or right, but I'm always on the wrong side of the screen. Fuck. That was stupid. Come on, let's let me get to Cleopatra. I'm on the opposite side. Well, that's what I thought, but then every time I do that, it's like, okay, I'm gonna get on the opposite side now, and then they juke me. Do it again. Switch sides again. I'm probably just moving over too soon, but I'm pretty sure I had the timing down for it at some point, but now I don't even remember. Yeah, I thought I was gonna go left, but it wasn't right. Up on it. Soon. Look for the fish. Is this it? Did I not get it? What? Did I not get it? Yo, I shot the fuck out of that thing. What's going on here? There it is. Okay, that was delayed. Yeah, Zeus, this is the hidden stage on Shock Troopers. Thank you. Zerst, I got 30.2 million on Shock Troopers, so I haven't actually put that in on the site yet, but... I'll be inserting that later. Shit. Sandbagging. I just have to, you can't submit a score without, you can't submit a first place score without proof. And so I have to make a, Twitch archive, and I'm still streaming right now, so I can't actually make the, not a Twitch archive, a Twitch highlight. I can't actually make the highlight right now because I'm still playing, so. I have no intention, I have no intention of sandbagging like a certain other team I can think of. DC. Yeah, 20 million clear, especially with blood on, is a good score. Like, not many people can do that. I like it end up being second place. Time's over. Every time I force myself into the corner. Yeah, sorry about that, Martin. I didn't get a score down, too. I can definitely improve that, too, but... it's not too bad for my second credit in quite a while. Mark Boys. Alright, now what should I play? Well, let me fix the thing on the dashboard since some people are still giving me shit about it. Y'all are savages. Can I not put in name as a game now? Fuck. Weird. I'm just leaving the shock troopers. You really want to see me play D2K? It's not going to be pretty. Like, part of me feels like just playing D2K up to the barrel stage and then just leeching all my lives on the barrel stage. You could probably do better that way than actually trying to play it out. Actually, there was one thing I wanted to try. So I watched an imp. I need to see if I can duplicate this. Ready, football! There we go. Nope, I fucked that up. I watched a replay where they got it perfect on all the blockers, and then they just ran it all the way to the end zone and got a 20,000 point bonus. This isn't gonna work. Damn, they speed up fast. Ready, football!
Ready, football! Up, up!
Let's run it in. Yeah, I get the feeling this game isn't a very accurate rendition of football. There we go. Nope, I fucked it up. It's harder than it looks. Oh god.
Ready, football! Up, 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 up!
Wow. Jesus. I will never stop thinking that they're saying, "Ready, football!" It's still funny to me. I don't know what they're supposed to be saying. It's ready football to me. Pretty good. Touchdown!
Ready, touchdown! Hot, 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 hot!
Not even a first down.
Ready, touchdown! Hot, 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 hot!
It kind of sounds like ready first down, but that doesn't make any sense when you're... especially when you're on second down. Oh, Jesus. Look how they all run after the ball like they're gonna get it. It's a fucking extra point. I don't get to do shit. Yeah, this game sounds in general just top notch. But the absolute best part, the funniest part of the game, somebody pointed out to me, I can never unhear it, is when you actually get a game over and run out of time. It's like the, you know, you hear the beep, the referee raises his hand like that, and then you wait for it, and then the referee raises his other hand, and you just hear a gunshot go off. It's just boom! We always like to joke that the referee's committing suicide. Suck that the referee's committing suicide. Sucks that the target's there. I'm sure if I don't fuck this up, I'll get game over on the next stage anyway, so. First down, first down, first down. You motherfucker! Just like in real football, an interception is 20 yards back. First downs. Gotta get all first downs now. Oh no, don't do it, ref, don't do it. You are the best record holder for today. What place did that even put me in? Seventh? It's not so bad. You know what? Fuck it. I can't believe I'm doing this. What the hell is the ROM name? I don't even know the ROM name for this. Shit, what is the... settings. I think I do. This game is so bullshit, we're using six lives. Love it. Whoops. Let's make new levels, and let's make them as unfun as possible. That sounds like a great idea. Everything on this game is based around doing shit the long way. In this. Who cares? Nobody's gonna ask me for proof on this. There was an arcade here in Barcade here in Salem. I'm not here in Salem, but I don't live in Salem. But when they opened, they had this Donkey Kong 2 in a regular Donkey Kong cab. And I don't think I ever saw one person play it and actually get past the screen. Like, people would put in a quarter, start playing, and then be really confused as to what the fuck is going on. Apparently, at least one person had gotten past the first screen, because there was a high score that was like, I think it was just barely above 20,000 or something like that. But everybody I saw, they didn't know what the fuck to do. I don't blame them. This is just a poorly designed game. And why start with that horrible first level instead of the familiar barrel stage? That was a terrible choice. Yeah, it's the only time I've seen a D2K on location. Not counting, like, the, I guess by on location, you mean, like, in an actual, a regular arcade. I've seen it in, like, the Northwest Pinball Classic Show, but, I mean, that doesn't really count, because that's not actually an arcade you can visit at any time. But, yeah, the Coin Jam in Salem did have D2K in their cabinet when they opened up. A couple months later, they realized the folly of their ways and put in, I think they put in Junior for some reason, but now it's regular Donkey Kong. Probably for the best. Thank you. Like, I think the shitty... Well, not these shitty, but one of the shitty things about this game is that a lot of these levels are so low scoring, it doesn't really make you feel like you're accomplishing much. I mean, you get most of your points from the old stages, because those are actually reasonable to finish with a decent bonus timer. Okay, this next level, I don't know how to do. Remember, you don't go there immediately. Let all this fall first. Bad jump. Oh god, I don't know how to do this. Thank you. Not this stage either. This game is ass. Game is super ass. Yeah. Oh, jumping the gun too early. It's like if you get past that part, it's not so hard, I think. Jump the gun this time. I can't get over there. There we go. Hey. Oh god, this jump is gonna be shitty, isn't it? Okay, I got it. Why would the fireballs come out so fast? Oh man, don't die on the first rivets. That would suck. As long as this guy doesn't come down. That wasn't the best idea. The rivet boards are not my strong suit on Donkey Kong Original. Oh yeah, they took that out. Yay, I cleared one level. Then it gets even harder. Now we got fireballs. Surely it's not going to do it a third time in a row. There's no way. No way. Okay, well, that one game, I feel like I have a better understanding of how to do this now. Wow, even the demo doesn't want to play this game. You see that? Like, it doesn't even go up the ladder. It jumps the flames, and then Jumpman ends it all. Oh my god, not Donkey Kong 2! What is this poorly designed level? What the f- He even stands there for a second, like, what the fuck is this? And then falls into the flames. Now, I'm gonna hate myself for this, but fuck it. I'm gonna try it one more time. I think I can do this. I can definitely get past 2-1. Definitely. I understand now. I understand how to get past that stupid cement generator. I understand how to get past the other conveyor belt stages. Why are there so many fucking conveyor belts? I don't understand how to do that, apparently. That's loud. But I do wonder what would happen if I spent all 7 or 8 lives just leeching on the barrel stage. That counts as a death? Really? 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 For some reason, I have the most problems with doing that fucking jump at the beginning. It's too late for me, Fax. Just end it all. I had a feeling. I should not be dying on the barrel stage. What? I was... pressing up. Why did he stop climbing? Eight-way joysticks. I swear to God, I was holding up. I don't think I hit the diagonals. Oh well, my first death was bad anyway. Side? I think it is. Uh-oh. Whew. progress the stage. Oh, come on! No! Why do they fall so slowly? Oh, right, this is a shitty game. The stage down. Jesus. That's okay. I don't care. Okay, now that fireball wants to go down, let him go down. For him to come back up. Cement factory. Oh my god! Why is that such a hard jump? Those first three fireballs come out so fast. Mm-hmm. I picked the worst time to do that. Why did I do that? Okay, that was all me. That was me being really stupid. Tell how shitty I am at Donkey Kong. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I wanted to keep that so I could get the hammer. But maybe I should focus on actually clearing this. This could be a problem. Whatever. Now let's just hope I can get past 2-1. Fireballs, fireballs. Patience. Now this is the shitty part. This game fucking sucks. Alright, I'm gonna cut the stream here. Maybe I'll do some more late night streaming in a little bit later. Once this room cools out a bit. I'm still kinda drenched in sweat right now. Thank you, Oregon Heatwave. But yeah, thanks for watching. Got a couple decent scores to put in. Peace.